every day. Lysol brand disinfectant, America's largest selling disinfectant. Ask for Lysol at your druggist today.
In this video, we'll talk about the bizarre and allegedly deadly history of Lysol. There have been weird forms of contraception throughout history. There's mercury, squatting and sneezing. And for my friend's mom and dad, it was baby powder. That's how they had them. Their oops babies. If I tell you today though that a woman can use Lysol to wash herself to prevent a pregnancy, you'd probably think I'm kidding. Or trying to give someone a bad chemical burn. And your skepticism and alarm are all quite healthy in this case. No one in this day and age would ever think that Lysol and their private parts down there should ever make contact with each other. But did you know that Lysol had quite an interesting history as a contraceptive back in the early to mid-1900s? Oh, Lysol had started off innocently enough in the late 1800s. It was initially sold to help end the cholera epidemic in Germany, then marketed as a way to prevent and fight the flu and an influenza pandemic in 1918. Between its innocent beginning then and its current reputation as a reliable all-around household cleaner, it was advertised in women's magazines as a post-coital douche to prevent pregnancies. Although technically not illegal in the US back in the day, state laws were passed to restrict contraceptives, including dissemination of information and distribution. Because of contraceptives going underground during this time, douching was the most common way to remain baby-free, until the oral contraceptive pill became popular in the 1960s and 1970s. During this time, Lysol was marketed as contraception in the guise of a feminine hygiene product. In this case, feminine hygiene was a euphemism for contraceptive. This ad claims Lysol passes the crucial test of a germicide in that it is effective in the presence of organic matter. One can deduce what that organic matter would be when a woman is trying to prevent pregnancy post having relations with a man. Before Lysol had changed its formula in 1953, it contained cresol, a phenol compound reported in some cases to cause inflammation, burning, and even death. Sadly, hundreds passed away from Lysol exposure deaths, and the product did not even work in preventing pregnancies, as a study that was conducted found that half of those that used it ended up pregnant anyways. Yikes. Thankfully, Lysol had said goodbye to its past of marketing its product for feminine hygiene. And doctors nowadays warn women against douching, as it can cause more harm and promote bacterial growth. It blows my mind though, how some of the stuff that we have in our homes today were marketed for an entirely different purpose. What other products that you know of had an interesting history as this? Let us know in the comments below.
If you like this video, please give us a thumbs up. For more interesting facts and stories, subscribe to our channel and click on the post notification button to know when we upload a new video. Remember, stay Fox curious.